Hello and welcome to another episode of Superintendent Spotlight. And yes, again, this is a carpool karaoke version because it seems like every time I ask someone or someone asks me if they want to do something, they want to be a carpool karaoke. So several weeks ago, I had a couple of seniors who are on my superintendent's council, which is a group of students, grades 9 through 12, that meet and discuss issues. We meet monthly, and we've been doing that for several years. So some of the seniors asked if they could be on a carpool karaoke. So I thought it would be really cool to get the perspective of students about the West Bridgewater Public Schools. I tend to keep interviewing people that are in charge of programs and so on and so forth. So I thought it would be cool to get that perspective from kids. So that's what we're going to do today. Pick up a couple of the seniors that are on the superintendent's council, and let's just have a conversation about all the great things West Bridgewater. Here we go. And there they are. Come on in, girls.
Hey.
Hello.
How are you?
Good.
How are you?
Good. Okay, you're good.
Okay, we're good.
You're all set? Okay, so I was telling our viewing audience that we are going to have a great perspective from a student perspective of all things West Bridgewater Public Schools.
Yes.
And so what I would like is for you to introduce yourself and tell a little bit about other things that you, everything that you do in the schools and
okay,
so they get to know you.
I'm Casey Willis. I'm a senior. I play softball, basketball, and volleyball. Yeah, that's about it.
Like that's not enough, right? You do a lot.
Mm-hmm. I hang out with Dr. Oakley all the time at Superintendent's Council because we're best friends.
Okay, now you're pushing it. But okay, next.
I'm Haley. I'm a senior, and I do volleyball. I'm student council president and a couple other clubs. I'm into the video production scene a lot. Yeah.
Okay.
I'm Hannah Flynn. I'm also a senior. And I am the manager of the volleyball team.
Yes.
I don't play sports.
Somebody just lost their tennis ball.
I know. Glad they didn't run out after it.
Okay. I'm the captain of the debate team and the secretary general of the Model United Nations, so more of like the argumentative stuff. And I'm also in student council and superintendent's council. And we're all like in the honor societies and stuff, like NHS and the community service clubs.
Okay, so you guys are pretty busy, and sounds like you took advantage of what the schools have to offer.
Yes, like to keep active.
So, can you tell me how the schools, you've been in these schools for 12, have you been this your whole system?
Yep.
Okay, so you started in kindergarten all the way through, and now you're seniors, and you're getting close to leaving us.
I know.
And we actually all have something in common because I've been here for a long time too, and I was, my first year as superintendent, you guys were all in first grade. So we've kind of gone through that together, and we have a lot of history because of that.
Mm-hmm.
And do you know how carpool karaoke works?
Yes.
Of course.
Speaking of history.
Speaking of history, it's time to sing. This is what we do.
Let's see.
You gotta help me. I'm losing my mind.
I even know this one.
All behind, thought we were going strong. I thought we were holding on. Are we?
No, they don't teach
you. No, they don't teach you this in school.
Now my heart's breaking and I don't know what to do. Thought we were going strong.
You're supposed to be clapping.
Thought
you can clap.
On. Are we?
Ready?
You and me got a whole lot of history. We could be the greatest thing that the world has ever seen. You and me got a whole lot of history. So we'll let it go. We can make some noise. We can live forever.
All of the rumors, all of the fights, but we always find a way to make it out alive. Thought we were going strong. Thought we were holding on. Aren't we?
You and me got a whole lot of history. We can be the greatest thing that the world has ever seen. You and me got a whole lot of history. So don't let it go. We can make some more. We can live forever.
I don't know the cars, basketball games, student council meetings.
Yes.
Did I make something up? Come on, come on, come on, go, 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 go. It's a good thing they don't do a part of the superintendent's evaluation on singing.
Yeah.
So, you know, but at least I have fun.
Exactly.
That's all that matters.
So tell me how the West Bridgewater Public Schools has helped you to become the young adults that you are. You've been here for 12 years. Obviously, there has to be some influence that it's had on you. Do you have any thoughts about that? And we can go in any order.
I think we can all say that having such like a small town, you have that personal connection with teachers, and that just makes you feel more comfortable to ask questions in and out of class, come to them for help, or like even if you're working on like side projects, that mainly happens like when you're older, you can like ask them for guidance and stuff. So it's just, you feel so comfortable in the community you're in.
Okay, so the comfort is has yeah. allowed you to be able to feel free and do more things, you think?
Like, if I think back to, like, sixth grade, middle school, like, all of that, like, I was always, like, the shy girl who didn't like to talk and, like, stuff, like, would never raise my hand. And, like, throughout high school, like, I found myself, like, blossoming almost and, like, becoming someone who would never be a part of a debate team or a Model United Nations Club. The teachers just, like, support you so much, and they make you believe that you can be a part of anything. And the school is so small that we don't have stereotypes. You can be a jock, and you can also be in student council. Like, there's no limit to what you can do. And that's, like, I think the most, like, useful thing that the school has, like, given me the opportunity. And I feel like a lot of kids going to college won't feel, like, and have the same, like, experience.
Wow, that's great. So it really piggybacks on what Casey said, that it's that smallness and that personalized relationships you have with teachers have given you the confidence. And now, no matter what you do, you'll have the confidence, even if it's in a situation where it's something bigger and you don't know people.
Yeah,
definitely. They just kind of give you the encouragement to do whatever you want. And I think that another thing with the school being so small is that there's so many opportunities to do whatever you want to do. You can do student council and be an athlete and do drama and do literally any other club that the school has to offer, because everyone, all the teachers are willing to make it work for you and your schedule, which I think is...
Yeah.
You know how good that is as a superintendent to feel that, to hear from you guys that it's, you know, the instruction, it's the teachers, it's that personal relationship. You said you were here pre-K through 12, I don't know, or K through 12?
Yeah.
So how about we go back in the Wayback Machine and think about your favorite memories of being a West Bridgewater student for 12 years? You must have some things that will always, always stick with you. What are they?
Okay, one of my longest memories that I've had is in kindergarten.
Okay, that's the Wayback Machine.
Yes, I was trying to like, go as far back as that's I possibly could, so if we're trying to go all the way back. My mom used to go on business trips a lot, and my dad would do my hair in the morning, and it didn't really go very well. So then when I showed up to school, Mrs. Weldon always used to do the Mrs. Weldon ponytail is what we called it, and she would like take me into the hallway, and she would fix my hair for me, and then I would go back to class, and I would go on with my day.
So she could tell that she looked at you and said, oh, your mom must be away.
Yeah, she knew. She knew. There was no telling any different.
That's great. Does your dad know that story? He will now. That's great. So we'll make sure that your father doesn't do you here before the next prom or
before the senior ball.
Yeah. Look, we won't have him do that.
Yeah. Oh, my God.
Okay. So that's a great memory. What else do we have?
one of my favorite memories is definitely from the Roselle. So when Mrs. Dubin was our, she was our principal when we were there, first through third grade.
Yeah.
And she had this song she would play every time we were at an assembly or just like gathering together. And it was, I Think You're Wonderful.
Oh.
And every time that song would come on, everybody, no matter who you were, no matter who you were friends with, what grade you were in, anything, we would all put our arms around each other and sit in a big, huge circle, the whole school. And we would just rock back and forth singing, I Think You're Wonderful. And there's like a whole song to it. And I still remember the words to this day. And like, I like I remember in third grade, like we like cried the last time that we heard it because like we were like, I can't believe
that's
we're
awesome.
Leaving the school. Like, yeah. And I still today, if I heard that song, I think I would cry. Like,
that is
it's like
awesome.
One of those like such a special memory. Like in a big school, you'd never have that.
No. So yeah. Can you give us a few bars of it as a group?
Well, we have to put our arms
it's
around
like,
each
okay,
other.
Okay,
right,
but you can't.
Right,
you can't
right,
hear.
Okay.
So you can pretend.
I think you're wonderful, as wonderful as can be. It makes me
want to
say.
Oh,
okay.
Sorry, I don't know the words as good.
Oh, something like that.
Okay.
I know
so you really didn't know the words, but anyway.
But
you
like
didn't
the
know
chorus.
Yeah, yeah. We'll
I held the team up.
Yeah.
Yes. That's what you did. That's awesome. And you know what? I know Mrs. Dubin will watch this. So you can give a shout out to Mrs. Dubin because she will be very excited that you have that as a memory because that's great.
Always will.
So.
I think another thing, like another one of my biggest memories are the trips that we've taken. So
yes.
Like, DC was a big one last year, which was super fun, and I think that the trips too, like, they gave us, like, a sense of independence, which was really
yeah,
nice, and
mm-hmm.
going back to our first trip, which was Nature's Classroom, and we got,
yes.
that was, like, the first time that we were all kind of on our own.
Well, and some of you, too, it might have been the first time that you stayed away that long with
yeah.
not being with your parents,
that
right?
That was my first
definitely.
Time being away from,
like
my
overnight?
Family, yeah, for, like,
how was
a
that?
Week.
Was that scary, or was it fine?
I thought it was fine. Like, we were so occupied the whole time, I don't really think I had any time to think, I miss my mom and dad. Because
that is a rite of passage for sixth
yeah.
graders. They still
yeah.
do
mm-hmm.
Nature's Classroom.
I think that's so good that they do that. And mm-hmm. and it's not like you feel alone because you're
no.
surrounded by people you know.
Right.
And, like, parents you know, which is really fun.
I remember
but.
Coming home, my mom was like, all right, like, go do the dishes. I was like, I wish I was in Nature's Classroom.
They do the dishes for me.
Yeah, she's like, and, like, I would, like, eat all my food off my plate. And be like, my mom would be like, wow, I'm so proud because at Nature's Classroom, you have to eat all your food
oh,
off
yeah.
your plate. They
the
don't,
big,
like,
wait
the
cycle.
Art report. I, like, was living by Nature's Classroom rules when I got home. My parents are like, what
yeah.
are you
They
doing?
Probably liked that.
Yeah.
yeah.
And I couldn't stop singing the Art Report song.
Yes. Yes.
Oh,
the
and.
Art Report.
I heard that there was another song.
Yes.
I heard there was another song that you have to show people.
There was our own
yes.
twist that was put on.
There was a twist to it, yeah.
Yes.
So being Carpool Karaoke.
Obviously.
I think it's only
appropriate.
And I know this because this is a way back machine for me. So I want to hear you singing that chorus, ladies.
Oh, don't worry.
Hey, where did we go? Days when the rains came down in the hollow, playing a new game, laughing and a running, hey, hey, skipping and a jumping.
Get into it!
In the misty morning, falling, all my hearts are thumping in you, my brown-eyed squirrel.
Let's hear it.
You're my brown-eyed squirrel.
All right, brown-eyed squirrel.
Yes. Whatever happened, the Tuesday ain't so slow. Going down the old man
I
with
can't
a
you.
Transistor radio. Standing in the sunlight laughing. Hiding high on the rainbow's wall. Slipping and sliding.
Ooh, I hear it coming.
All along the waterfall with you.
Let's hear it.
My brown-eyed squirrel. You, my brown-eyed squirrel.
All right, now I want to hear it.
Do you remember when we used to sing sha-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la
la 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 di da, la di da.
Oh,
a brown-eyed squirrel. You, my brown-eyed squirrel. Do you remember when?
Everybody.
we used to sing. Sha-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la- la 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 la
la la. An interesting perspective because you were in the old building for 3 years and you're in the new building for 3 years. So you really got to see the difference and why this town fought for getting a new high school.
Yeah.
Tell me the difference. What has it improved for you? Has it helped your educational experience? What are the first things that come to mind about the difference between
the two? Well, for starters, there's no ceiling tiles falling on anyone's head.
Yeah,
so,
that's true. That's
so
true.
It's a win.
Yeah, that's a win.
That's
a
pro. If nothing else, it improved. The ceiling tiles. That improving is enough.
But I think from, like, a science department perspective, the labs are so much better now. We have so much more, like, material available to us, and you can do so much more. I can't really compare the classes that I didn't take in the old school, but, like, just hearing what my sister did in, like, chemistry class, I feel like we did way more when we had the new building because we just had new material to work with.
Yeah.
But I think technology itself has just grown as we got into the new building with our Chromebooks, which was super helpful and still is. Like, being able to take those home and have a lot of our homework on the computer is really easy.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And then the video, from that perspective, there's all new equipment, and even if I weren't a part of the morning crew where they do the announcements or whatever, it's a lot easier to watch the announcements than it is to listen. Just the other day, there was, like, a virus that was in the computer, so we didn't have it that one day, and I got so much more watching the day before than listening the day after.
Yeah.
I, like, definitely, like, honestly, the new school, it kind of, like, feels like you're getting, like, that private school feel almost, because it's just, like, there's so much to access, and, like, the fact that we have Chromebooks, like, I can't even remember life without them.
No.
Like, I don't know what I would do without my Chromebook, like.
So you definitely think that was worthwhile.
Yeah.
And it has everything in it, too, like, it's so
and
easy.
And the school's
convenient.
So compatible with the.
And
there's
so many, like, different teaching styles now that, like, something that your teacher's going to do is going to work for you.
Exactly.
So.
There's so many different ways, like, if you're not a learner, like, through, like, Google Classroom, there's always something else you can use.
We get, as you know, a lot of kids from out of town through our inter-district school choice program that apply and are accepted to the schools. And, you know, you guys have been in West Bridgewater your whole life, but you've seen a lot of kids come in through the school choice program, and you're probably friends with a lot of them. And so my question to you is, if you happen to be at something, like you were at a sporting event somewhere, or when you were in PCC, if you did that, or any other types of things you are at out of town, and someone said, hey, you know what, I'm thinking of applying to your school for school choice, but I'm not sure. Should I? Shouldn't I? What would you tell them?
I would tell them that in West Bridgewater, you're not a number, you're a name.
Yeah.
Like, and everybody knows you. Like, I hurt my back last year, and, like, the nurse, before I could even go see her, she's like, how's your back? Like, the teachers were like, oh, like, I heard. Like, and, like, students will just come up to you and be like, oh, like, I saw you, like, at the game the other day, or, like, nobody's afraid, like, there's not, like, nobody's afraid to say hi to anyone, like, you're always, like, a name, like, people always, like, care about you, and, like, that's just such a nice feeling to go somewhere every single day and feel like you matter, and you don't get that in a lot of other towns.
And teachers definitely put you as, a priority, and not just, like, somebody they need to teach to do their job.
Yes, I think, like, again, going back to the teacher connection thing, like, it's just something that you're not gonna get anywhere else, really, because it's so important to the teachers and the students and the administration, and that's something that's, like, really pushed, and they really care about the students as individuals, not just as, oh, what grade did you get on your paper? Like,
exactly.
So it's definitely that, again, personalization piece. So, you know, some larger schools might have the opportunity to offer maybe a few more electives or different things like that, but do you think that going to the smaller school and having the personalization outweighs that?
For sure.
Yeah, because teachers can bring certain opportunities to you, or, like, it's easier to get involved in a smaller school because you can be head of anything if you're that passionate about it.
Yeah.
I've never, like, found myself saying, like, oh, like, I wish I was at a bigger school so I could do this. Like, West Bridgewater presents all those opportunities. It's just you have to, like, you just look for them. And if I said to a teacher, like, oh, we don't have this type of club. Like, I'd love to start one. Like, we didn't have a Model United Nations club, but we started one. Like, the teachers are just like, you can, there's just so many opportunities.
They listen to you.
If you want something and you put the work in, you can have it. You can have anything that a big school can offer you. I've never felt like, like, I don't have the access to that.
Yeah, like volleyball, too.
Yeah,
exactly.
I remember starting that in our sophomore year, and it was a club, and it was really cool to be able to watch it grow and have the support of the school behind us, too.
Mm-hmm. So you feel that your voices are heard, and you do have student voice in West Bridgewater?
Very much
Absolutely.
Not only with, like, in our school, but, like, we can, we feel comfortable talking to you, which I think is kind of cool, and no other school systems,
what
I think.
What other school system can you say? Yeah. Oh, yeah, I went Carpool Karaoke with
the superintendent.
No,
I don't think many other superintendents are Carpool Karaoke with the kids. But honestly, I think that's part of West Bridgewater, too, and part of why I love West Bridgewater, because as a superintendent in a small district, I get to stay close to kids, and I went into teaching for that reason. When you're a superintendent maybe in a bigger district, you get away from the kids, and that's not why I went into education.
Yeah.
So it makes sense. But I will say, it seems to keep coming back to small town feel, big school opportunities.
Yeah.
Like, you still have big school opportunities, but that small town feel. So I picked a song that I want to play, and I'm sure that you've all heard of it, and will sing along with me.
Yes.
Sure.
Right?
Yeah.
Let's see. Do you know this one? Who knows John Mellencamp?
Part of it.
Come on. You don't know?
Maybe we'll know what the words are.
Yes.
Wait a minute. Here we go. I was born in a small town.
And it's all about you.
In a small town.
Come on.
In a small town.
Small town.
That's the only word you know. Come on, one more time.
Small town.
Tell me what you would give for advice to underclassmen to make the West Bridgewater experience the best it could possibly be.
Get involved.
Take advantage of any opportunity.
You're going to regret not doing something more than doing something.
So many, like, people, like, senior year all of a sudden are like, wait, I want to be a part of that. Like, how did you? I'm like, I've been in this club since freshman year.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
I've been here this whole time. You just have to look.
Even if you don't feel super comfortable joining a club, just do it. They love new members.
Even now, or I just sports teams. Yeah, I decided to join drama as, like, a last-minute spring musical senior year decision. And it's really fun, and I didn't give it enough credit or, like, chance or opportunity, because I always thought, like, oh, I'm doing this, so I shouldn't do this, too.
Okay.
And she's not a great singer.
Yeah, no, horrible. I mean, you're hearing it right now.
What are you talking about, Adele?
Yes, you're right. Sorry, I'm Adele. No, but it was just, like, it's really cool to be able to do those things, and I think that it's really important that you get involved earlier, because that's something that I wish that I had joined earlier, just to have fun with friends and meet new people, and it's been really cool being able to talk to new people that I wouldn't normally be interacting with in other clubs.
Mm-hmm. And what's this spring musical going to be?
Mary Poppins.
Okay.
Yes. Oh, my God. Everybody go and watch.
So who gets to sing supercalifragilisticexpialidocious, even though the sound of it is something
like that? Yeah, I am in that.
If you say it loud enough, they'll always be precocious. Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious.
I'm the lead in the play. I'm a statue.
Does that horrify you?
That kind of horrifies me. I don't. Nope. I would never be able to. That is impressive.
Can you spell the word?
You should put that on your resume. I can sing.
We have to do it in sign language too, so.
What?
Oh, yeah.
I love Mary. Oh, I can't wait.
Okay.
That's great. What date? You might as well get a shout out for the date.
Oh, yeah. So I'll throw it out here. April 6th and 7th. The shows at night are on Friday and Saturday at 7, and there's one in the day on Saturday at 2.
Excellent. So would you feel that you really had the time of your life here?
Yes.
And that was a really bad segue into this.
That was
it was so good. I really appreciated it.
Oh, stop messing it up. I don't know why it starts that way. Okay, I want to hear this one.
Okay.
Okay? Because this is...
Yeah.
And don't, no crying.
When the turning point, a fork stuck in the road.
You know these words?
Yes. You by the rest, directs you where to go. So make the best of this test and know that's why. It's not a question, but a lesson learned in time. It's something unpredictable, but in the end it's right. I hope you had the time of your life.
Should I play the guitar?
You gotta love Green Day. See, this is an oldie, but you know.
Yeah, oldie, but goodie.
So take the photographs and still frames in your mind. Hanging on a shelf in good health and good time. Tattoos and memories and that's in a trial. For what it's worth, it was worth all the while. It's something unpredictable, and in the end it's right. I hope you had the time of your life.
Don't cry.
Haley,
don't
cry
about
crying
everything.
The drop of a pin, you mentioned
what's
cry,
the thing you'll miss
gone.
Most about West Bridgewater schools?
There's a lot.
Give me one.
Probably that I feel comfortable to talk to anybody, and I already know everyone, and that, I don't know, just
next.
West Bridgewater as a whole.
I'm going to miss the people the most,
yes.
The teachers, the kids,
yes.
The administration, literally everyone, everything.
I'm gonna miss being involved in just everything. Like, part in everything.
I hope you had the time of your life.
I feel like we should, like,
do the way.
It's something unpredictable, and in the end, it's right. I hope you had the time of your life.
I really do hope you had the time of your life.
I think it's, yeah.
And I'm very happy that I got to be a part of it. So let's really rock it out for the end.
Okay, yeah, get out of this crying phase we're in right here.
Because this is the ultimate rocking out song in a car, right?
It is.
And you are small town girls, so.
We are. Depends on the lyrics,
but yes, we do.
Because I do.
I think the song's about us.
It was written for us.
Just a small town girl, living in a lonely world. She took a midnight train going anywhere. Just a city boy, born and raised in South Detroit. Took the midnight train going anywhere.
Your old Howard school.
The Howard.
The playground.
The playground.
So many injuries there.
Some preschool memories.
Yeah.
A singer in a smoky room. The smell of wine is cheap perfume. For a smile that can share the night, it goes on and on and on and on. Strangers waiting up and down the boulevard. Their shadows searching in the night. Streetlights. Living just to find emotion, hiding somewhere in the night.
That one was good.
No, don't stop believing. Hold on to that feeling. Streetlights, people.
I really appreciate you coming, and I think people got a really good idea of all the things about the school, and you guys were so emotional and
emotional.
about all the good things that go on the West Bridgewater Public Schools, because a lot of times I have people and we talk about programs and policies and all that stuff, but to hear it from, you guys are there all the time.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So to hear all those good things from kids, and that's what we're here for, I really appreciate
it.
Get to practice.
Thank you.
Oh, no, you got a big game. Big game tonight.
Thank you very much.
Big game.
Thank you.
Well, that was another Carpool Karaoke with our seniors, three of our seniors, and I think you can see that they really have had a great experience in the West Bridgewater Public Schools. They have learned a lot. They've become really great young adults, and I hope that it really just gives you an insight of all the great things that go on here, and it really made me feel like, wow, we're here for kids, and we really are doing what we're supposed to do here. We're fulfilling our mission for the kids and making them college and career and world ready. And I'm very proud to hear that they feel the same thing, and the respect that they have for the teachers and the community, and how proud they are. And, you know, a lot of times in this day and age, we hear things about kids and, oh, kids don't care, they're this, they're apathetic. They're not. We heard their voices today. They love what we're doing here in West Bridgewater, and they're going to be better young adults because of it. So thanks again for watching, and we'll see you next time on Superintendent Spotlight.